The angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary,
and she conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh,
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech you, O Lord, to pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion, we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father,
and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The mercy of the Lord is everlasting.
Come, let us adore him.
Come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and raise our shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. Come, let us adore him.
Teaching, O my people. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth.
I will open my mouth in a parable. I will declare the mysteries of ancient times.
That which we have heard and known, and what our forefathers have told us, we will not hide from their children.
We will recount to generations to come the praiseworthy deeds and the power of the Lord, and the wonderful works he has done.
He gave his decrees to Jacob and established a law for Israel, which he commanded them to teach their children,
that the generations to come might know, and the children yet unborn, that they in their turn might tell it to their children,
so that they might put their trust in God and not forget the deeds of God, but keep his commandments,
and not be like their forefathers, a stubborn and rebellious generation. The generation whose heart was not steadfast and whose spirit was not faithful to God.
The people of Ephraim, armed with a bow, turned back in the day of battle.
They did not keep the covenant of God and refused to walk in his law.
They forgot what he had done and the wonders he had shown them.
He worked marvels in the sight of their forefathers, in the land of Egypt, in the field of Zoar.
He split open the sea and let them pass through. He made the waters stand up like walls.
He led them with a cloud by day, and all the night through with a glow of fire.
He split the hard rocks in the wilderness, and gave them drink as from the great deep.
He brought streams out of the cliff, and the waters gushed out like rivers.
But they went on sinning against him, rebelling in the desert against the Most High.
They tested God in their hearts, demanding food for their craving.
They railed against God and said, can God set a table in the wilderness?
True, he struck the rock, the waters gushed out, and the gullies overflowed. But is he able to give bread or provide meat for his people?
When the Lord heard this, he was full of wrath. A fire was kindled against Jacob, and his anger mounted against Israel.
For they had no faith in God, nor did they put their trust in his saving power.
So he commanded the clouds above and opened the doors of heaven.
He rained down manna upon them to eat and gave them grain from heaven.
So mortals ate the bread of angels. He provided for them food enough.
He caused the east wind to blow in the heavens and led out the south wind by his might.
He rained down flesh upon them like dust, and winged birds like the sand of the sea.
And let it fall in the midst of their camp, and round about their dwellings.
So they ate and were well filled, for he gave them what they craved.
But they did not stop their craving, for the food was still in their mouths.
So God's anger mounted against them. He slew their strongest men and laid low the youth of Israel.
In spite of all this, they went on sinning and had no faith in his wonderful works.
So he brought their days to an end like a breath, and their years in sudden terror.
Whenever he slew them, they would seek him and repent and diligently search for God.
They would remember that God was their rock, and the Most High God, their Redeemer.
But they flattered him with their mouths, and lied to him with their tongues.
Their heart was not steadfast toward him, and they were not faithful to his covenant.
But he was so merciful that he forgave their sins and did not destroy them. Many times he held back his anger and did not permit his wrath to be roused.
For he remembered that they were but flesh, a breath that goes forth and does not return.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The prophet Nehemiah, the 9th chapter, beginning at the 26th verse. Ezra said to the Lord, "Nevertheless, they were disobedient and rebelled against you, and cast your law behind their backs, and killed your prophets, who had warned them in order to turn them back to you, and they committed great blasphemies. Therefore you gave them into the hands of their enemies, who made them suffer. Then, in the time of their suffering, they cried out to you, and you heard them from heaven, and according to your great mercy, you gave them saviors who saved them from the hands of their enemies. But after they had rest, they again did evil before you, and you abandoned them to the hands of their enemies, so that they had dominion over them. Yet when they turned and cried to you, you heard from heaven, and many times you rescued them according to your mercies, and you warned them in order to turn them back to your law. Yet they acted presumptuously and did not obey your commandments, but sinned against your ordinances, by the observance of which a person shall live. They turned a stubborn shoulder and stiffened their neck and would not obey. Many years you were patient with them and warned them by your spirit through your prophets, yet they would not listen. Therefore you handed them over to the peoples of the land. Nevertheless, in your great mercies, you did not make an end of them or forsake them, for you are gracious and merciful God. Now, therefore, our God, the great and mighty and awesome God, keeping covenant and steadfast love, do not treat lightly all the hardship that has come upon us, upon our kings, our officials, our priests, our prophets, and our ancestors, and all your people, since the time of the kings of Assyria until today. You have been just in all that has come upon us, for you have dealt faithfully and we have acted wickedly. Our kings, our officials, our priests, and our ancestors have not kept your law or heeded the commandments and the warnings that you gave them. Even in their own kingdom, and in the great goodness you bestowed on them, in the large and rich land that you set before them, they did not serve you and did not turn from their wicked works. Here we are, slaves to this day, slaves in the land that you gave to our ancestors to enjoy its fruit and its good gifts. Its rich yield goes to the kings whom you have set over us because of our sins. They have power over our bodies and over our livestock at their pleasure, and we are in great distress. Because of all this, we make a firm agreement in writing, and on that sealed document are inscribed the names of our officials, our Levites, and our priests. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A song of God's herald. Go up to a high mountain,
herald of good tidings to Zion.
Lift up your voice with strength,
herald of good tidings to Jerusalem.
Lift up your voice, fear not.
Say to the cities of Judah, behold your God. See the Lord God coming with power, coming to rule with his mighty arm.
He brings
his reward for the people of God, the recompense for those who are saved. God will feed his flock like a shepherd, and gather the lambs in his arms. He will hold them to his breast, and gently lead those that are of young.
Glory
to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Revelation to John, the 18th chapter, beginning at the 9th verse. The kings of the earth, who committed fornication and lived in luxury with her, Babylon, will weep and wail over her when they see the smoke of her burning. They will stand far off in fear of her torment and say, alas, alas, the great city, Babylon, the mighty city, for in 1 hour your judgment has come. And the merchants of the earth weep and mourn for her, since no one buys their cargo anymore, cargo of gold, silver, jewels and pearls, fine linen, purple, silk and scarlet, all kinds of scented wood, all articles of ivory, all articles of costly wood, bronze, iron and marble, cinnamon, spice, incense, myrrh, frankincense, wine, olive, choice flour and wheat, cattle and sheep, horses, chariots, slaves, and human lives. The fruit for which your soul longed has gone from you, and all your dainties and your splendor are lost to you, never to be found again. The merchants of these wearers, who gained wealth from her, will stand far off, in fear of her torment, weeping and mourning aloud. Alas, alas, the great city, clothed in fine linen, in purple and scarlet, adorned with gold, with jewels and with pearls. For in 1 hour all this wealth has been laid waste. All shipmasters and seafarers, sailors and all who trade in the sea, stood far off and cried out as they saw the smoke of her burning. What city was like the great city? And they threw dust on their heads as they wept and mourned, crying, alas, alas, the great city, where all her ships at sea grew rich by her wealth, for in 1 hour she has been made waste. Rejoice over her, O heaven, you saints and apostles and prophets, for God has given judgment for you against her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A song of the Spirit. Behold, I am coming soon, says the Lord. I'm bringing my reward with me, to bring to everyone according to their deeds. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who do
God's commandments,
that they may have the right to the tree of life, and may enter into the city through the gates. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to you, with his testimony for all the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David. I am the bright morning star. Come, says the Spirit and the Bride. Come, let each hearer reply. Come forward, you who are thirsty. Let those who desire take the water of life as a gift. To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb, be blessing and honor and glory and might, forever and ever. Amen. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord.
And grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
And let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
O God, whose blessed Son came into the world that he might destroy the works of the devil and make us children of God and heirs of eternal life, grant that, having this hope, we may purify ourselves as he is pure, that when he comes again with power and great glory, we may be made like him in his eternal and glorious kingdom, where he lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers, which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in your vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you, through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. God of mercy and compassion, of grace and reconciliation, pour your power upon all your children in the Middle East, Jews, Muslims, and Christians, Palestinians and Israelis. Let hatred be turned into love, fear to trust, despair to hope, oppression to freedom, occupation to liberation, that violent encounters may be replaced by loving embraces, and peace and justice could be experienced by all. This we ask through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies,
we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.